Welcome children to our maths lecture. Today we will be learning lesson number 15, statistics. Lesson number 14 we have completed in our previous video lecture. Now the new topic, statistics. In this lesson, children, we are going to study how to use the given data to find its you can say a short method, a shortcut to find its short value. That is we are going to study in this lesson. One topic is average, how to find average. Second topic that we are going to study is tally marking. Now these two things, average and tally marking or tally marks, these two are useful in mathematics to get the answer quickly. Okay, to get the answer in a very short method without lengthy calculations. Okay, now average, now what is there, how to find the average? The two points are important, see on the board. The samples that we have of the quantity we are measuring are called reading or scores. Means whatever quantities are there, for example, the reading, different readings of different days, or different measurement of the rainfall every day. Then how to find average, means 1 week every day the measurement is taken of the rainfall. Then what is the average rainfall of that week or of that month? Those things, they are said that given data, every day's reading is said to be score or reading. Then how to find average? Average is found by sum of all the scores. Whatever score is, score means whatever data is given in the question, divided by number of scores. Divided by number of scores. So the quotient obtained by dividing the sum of all scores in the given data by the total number of scores is called average. And average is equal to sum of all scores divided by total number of scores. So this, if you want, you can write down as an important point, and we will move on to practice set 54. Now one sentence I would like to tell. Average is used to find approximate value of scores given in data. Means approximate value, how to find out? We can find out using the method of average. Okay. So first question you can see in practice set 54. The daily rainfall for each day of a week in a certain city is given in millimeters. Find the average rainfall during the week. Means in a week there are 7 days, right? 7 days, each day rainfall is given in millimeters. So we have to tell in 1 week what was the average rainfall of that certain area or of that certain region. Okay, the numbers given are 9 11 8 20 10 16 and 12, and how many scores are, these are said to be scores, and how many are there? So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 scores are there. So average we will find by adding all these numbers divided by 7 will give us the average rainfall of that week. Okay, so let us calculate. Practice set 54. First sum. So first we will write down average rainfall. Average rainfall is equal to sum of rainfall each day of week
divided by number of bees. Now, each rainfall means you will be writing 9 plus 11 plus. After 11, what is the number? 8 plus 20 plus. After 20, 10. 10 plus 16 plus 12. Now, how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Divided by 7. Now, this total, 9 plus 11 plus 8 plus 20 plus 10 plus 16 plus 12 gives us as 86 divided by 7 gives us 12.28. The division gives us 12.28. So, we can say the average rainfall, the average rainfall during the week is 12.28 millimeters. Okay, 12.28 millimeters. So this is the first sum. Okay, so I will be doing children two sums, and then two sums you can do as homework. So this is the first sum taken down. Okay, now let us move for the second one. Second sum. Let us see the question. Second one. During the annual function of a school, a woman's self-help group had set up a snack stall. Their sales every hour were rupees 960, rupees 830, rupees 945, rupees 800, rupees 847, rupees 970 respectively. So this is the earning of per hour. What was the average of the hourly sale? Means, these are the, how many numbers are there children, count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers. Means 6 hours their sale is given. So you have to find what is the average earning of 1 hour. So same manner we will be doing here. Average sale will be equal to sum of sale every hour upon number of hours. Now let us write the earnings. Earnings are 960 plus 830 plus 945 plus 800 plus 847 plus 970. This upon 6. So this gives me answer as 5352 divided by 6, which gives me answer. When you divide, you get the answer as rupees 892. So therefore, the average hourly sale is rupees 892. Okay, so this is the second answer. Answer is 892. So same way children, you have to do some number 3 and 4. I'll just tell you what you can write as statement. The annual rainfall in Vidarbha in 5 years is given below. What is the average rainfall for those 5 years? The numbers are given, so you can write the statement. Average rainfall is equal to sum of annual rainfall in 5 years upon number of years. So that will be 900 plus 650 plus 450 plus 733 plus 400 divided by 5. Whatever answer you will get in millimeters. Fourth one, a farmer bought some sacks of animal feed. The weights of the sacks are given below in kilograms. What is the average weight of this sack? Average weight of the sack will be equal to sum of the weight of each sack upon number of sack. Then you will write all the weights, add and divide by how much? There are 8 sacks, so divide by 8. So whatever answer you get, that will be your answer in kg. It will be in kilogram. So such simple sum it is, children, to find the average. Again I tell you, you will add the data and divide it by number of numbers given. So do the two sums as homework in your classwork. Have fun. Be safe at home. Thank you.